Hey there. In this video series on Cubase AI and LE, we've been looking at how you can create music quickly and effectively. In this video, we're going to look at how you plug your electric guitar in, get it set up to record, and some very simple recording techniques so that you get the best result out of the takes that you've recorded. First up, the most important thing is to get everything set up and ready to record, and that includes getting your guitar ready. You don't need to have a guitar amplifier. You can simply plug a lead straight into your guitar and then into your audio interface. In this case, we're using a Steinberg UR22 Mark II, and we've plugged it into the second channel, which has a high Z input, which is designed specifically for the electric guitar. Next up, we're going into the studio setup, and we're just going to make sure that we've got the right audio interface selected. That's my interface, so I'm using that. Now, if you're using an interface and you're playing the guitar and you can hear some latency, you may need to check your buffer size. A lower buffer size will mean less delay when you're playing over the top of your track. A higher buffer size may be better for mixing later on in the production process. Next up, we're going to create an audio track to record the electric guitar on. So I've selected an audio channel, and now I'm selecting the second input on my audio interface. I'm creating a mono track because the guitar track is only one channel. Now I'm naming the track, and when I'm finished and select Add Track, this new track appears in my track list. I can extend the view just by dragging down here. I can also colorize my track so that every different instrument or every different production part has a different color, which makes it easier to see. You need to make sure that you've got the volume on your electric guitar turned up. And that means you can hear the guitar through the software. And I can see that the guitar is monitoring through that second red channel down the bottom in my mix console, which is the input channel. But now I need to turn on the monitor so that I can hear the guitar in the software. And now the guitar is also monitoring on the guitar track that I've just created. So the most important thing now is to make sure that my guitar is in tune. Cubase AI and LE comes with a built-in tuner, and we can add it as an insert in the insert slot. So now it's a matter of playing your guitar strings one by one and checking that they're in tune on the built-in tuner. If you're finding that the responsiveness of the tuner is a little laggy, then you probably need to go back and check your latency and buffer size settings. You can change the view of the tuner between classic and strobe, depends on what you're used to. Now we need to check the input gain, and I'd suggest playing as hard as you possibly can. If it's too loud, you'll start to see a red warning signal underneath the input channel itself. So there's one right there underneath the second red input channel. So I need to turn the audio interface down. One of the awesome things about recording in a DAW is you don't have to play everything from start to finish. You can choose sections to record at a time, and you can set up a cycle record point, and that means it's going to loop backwards and forwards. To do that, you grab the left locator and move it to the start point, and then grab the right locator, which is situated at the top of the project area window, and move it left to the finish point. Now we need to turn on the cycle record mode, which is down in the transport bar. Once you do that, you'll notice that those locator points have gone blue. So all we need to do now is hit record and start recording. Now I'm just going to let this loop backwards and forwards and have a jam over the top and just keep playing to try and find an idea. And don't stress, you don't need to find an idea straight away. Sometimes I let this loop backwards and forwards for 10, 15, 20 minutes before I find something that I like. And I think it's about relaxing in your own recording environment and taking time to find an idea that's going to work for your song. Now I'm going to speed this up, but as you can see, it's basically looping backwards and forwards and backwards and forwards over the same track so that I've got a number of different recording performances captured. I could now create a new track for a new take, or simply double or duplicate the guitar part that I've already recorded, give it a name, and delete the information on the track. Now if I activate the record enable button and make sure the monitor button is activated, I can start recording guitar very quickly on the next track that I've just created. And now I can try and find another part. There's something really cathartic about recording in this manner because there's no rush. Just let the DAW loop it backwards and forwards and take the time you need to find an idea and then find another idea that complements your original idea. Electric guitars that are plugged straight into an interface can sound quite harsh, and that's because they were designed to go through guitar amplifiers. And in Cubase AI and LE, we've got an amp simulator that we can use to add extra tone and distortion to the guitar sound that we've recorded. As soon as the amp simulator's loaded up, you can hear the generic settings, but now you can take your time and go through and find some settings that are going to work for your track. You can even change things like the guitar amplifier and the cabinet, and there's a number of different genres that you can choose between to try and find something that's going to work for you. And of course, you can continue to adjust things like distortion and presence and EQ. And if you're a little bit lost, there's a lot of presets in there that you can use to start to find something that might work for you straight away. Cubase AI and LE comes packed with a number of included effects, so there's lots of options for you to enhance the sound even after you've recorded it. For me, recording electric guitars means finding the right recording space, and that means adding ambience. So I've added the mono delay, and now I'm just going through the different parameters to try and find something that's going to warm this tone up even further. When I like what I've got, I can go down to the mix console and go to inserts and copy and paste these effects over onto the second track by holding down Alt and Option on my computer keyboard and dragging them across. I can create some stereo width by panning these tracks, and at the moment, I've still got the monitor on the second electric guitar track, so once I deactivate that, I can hear the track and I can start to blend these two guitar tracks in with the production of the track itself. So it's always important to mix as you go along. One of the awesome things about recording in cycle mode is that we've stored up a number of takes, which we can access here in this triangle at the bottom of the event. And now we can switch in between all of the different recorded takes and find something that works for us. If there's parts that are good and parts that aren't so good, we can get our scissors and we can go through and start to chop up the different takes on the different tracks. This is another incredible thing about recording in a DAW. You're not relying on one whole take the whole way through to be perfect. You can chop it up into different sections, and then you can go through and compare your different performances over the course of those individual sections. The more you break these parts down, the more options you have when it comes to editing in between individual takes. In music production, it's really important to control the dynamics of each individual track, and we do that through using things like compressors. We can access the channel strip through this channel overview window and access presets that have been designed by engineers for specific instruments. So I'm going with a really tight guitar sound here, and that means that it's loaded a compressor. Now, this compressor's job is to reduce the difference between the loudest and the softest parts of my track. And it does that using the threshold and the ratio. And there's a few other parameters that we can use to control how quickly it works. But there's a lot of videos on using compressors on the Cubase YouTube channel. Take the time to go and check them out. But for now, go with the presets that are included with the software. Now, this channel strip preset also includes a generic guitar EQ. And I'm going to go into the second guitar channel and also load another preset so that my guitars are fairly well balanced in terms of the dynamic control over the tracks. And if I need to, I can make small edits using the parameters inside the interface in the compressor in the channel strip. Thanks for stopping by and checking this video out. There's more coming up in the video series on Cubase AI and LE. Please like the video if you've learned something and subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel for plenty more videos just like this. I'll see you in the next video.